London had the Soviet Union still existed, tomorrow would have been its grandest moment, the day in which the self-proclaimed worker state would have celebrated with huge military parades and popular demonstrations the 100th anniversary of the Bolshevik Revolution, which heralded the birth of the world's first communist state. As it happens, Russia is holding this week both a grand military display and a lot of other festivities. Yet none of these is directly connected to that great Red Revolution a century ago. Instead, the festivities in Moscow are designed to mark National Unity Day, a holiday which Russian President Vladimir Putin invented out of nowhere a few years ago, precisely in order to divert the attention of ordinary Russians from that old communist takeover. Few anniversaries illustrate Russia's historic predicament better than this episode. This is a country desperate to forget its bloody past, yet somehow never able to do so. But then, neither has the rest of the world. For although nobody who is alive a century ago is still with us today, the Bolshevik Revolution, which unfolded in November 1917, still haunts us to this day. Counterfactual history, the attempt to guess what might have happened if things turned out differently, is a popular pastime. But ultimately, this is an intellectual game rather than a science. Still, history counterfactuals do serve a scientific purpose. They help us measure the sheer magnitude of a past event. And judging by this yardstick, there is no question that the Red Revolution of a century ago was of monumental significance, of historic rupture which literally shook the world, as John Reed, the American journalist who wrote the first Western eyewitness account of that event, rightly named it. Without that revolution, it is possible that World War I would have ended differently, and World War II would have never happened. Without that Red Revolution, it is likely that we would not have had the Cold War, that China would not have turned communist, North Korea would not have existed, and Europe would have been a very different continent. And without that November Revolution, it is certain that tens of millions of ordinary human beings would have not ended their lives starved, shot or confined to other indescribable forms of torture, either because they dared hope for a different existence, or sometimes for no reason at all apart from the fact that some Soviet communist official had an officially imposed daily quota of executions to fulfill.